The Joel and the Bang Show Music Hour has been known to make people scream, jam, bang their heads, dance around. So if you're listening, get ready to rock your face off.
Welcome to the show from the band Nothing Sounds Good, all the way from Puyallup, Washington, which is just south of Seattle, Washington, if you don't know your geography that well. Sleazy Vegetable Joe, welcome to the show.
Woo! Thank you, man. Thank you for having me.
No problem, man. I mean, I'm just glad to have you aboard. Your band won the 2018 Banger Music Award. Best Metal Song.
It was Best Metal Song.
Yes.
I was flabbergasted. I was just like, woo, I can't believe it. I mean, I feel like I've been venerated, you know?
Well, you guys sent me your stuff, I think it was last summer. And that gets you in the rotation. And once you're in the rotation, then you have your shot at becoming a nominee. And then you became the nominee. Next thing you know, you're winning.
It was awesome. I appreciate every single one of your fans and listeners that voted for our band. Thank you all very much.
And I have to say, I think you had a few of your fans voting. That's just what I'm saying.
We definitely pushed it.
So why don't you give a little history on the band?
Okay, well, let's start with the birth of the name. When the band first started playing, when we were rehearsing and writing songs, we couldn't come up with a name, and I wanted the band's name to be Nothing. Absolutely a blank screen, nothing. And the drummer at the time was like, well, we can't market Nothing. And I was like, okay, we'll come up with a better name. And we spent, and I'm being honest, we spent 2.5 months and wrote every idea of a name that we could on all kinds of paper. I mean, we had like 100 sheets of paper with names on it. And eventually we all got together for practice one day. And it's like, nope, 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 nope. You know what? Nothing sounds good. And everyone's just like, that's it. Because I wanted nothing, and nothing sounds good, and it was like an epiphany happened. Boom, where Nothing Sounds Good. And I hate to date it, but that was back in 1993.
Is that how long the band's been together?
This band has been playing on and off since 1993. We were pretty hard at it from 93 till about 2000, and then I got into another band, and I couldn't do both bands at once, so I sequestered this band for a while. And when I got out of the other band, I got back with the drummer and we started playing again. That was in, I'm going to say 2008. And I've had a couple of lineup changes. And I've actually, when this band started, I was just the bass player. And then I became the bass player vocalist. And then I became the vocalist. And now I'm the bass player vocalist again.
And you know, I lived back in Seattle from 95 to just about 2000. We might have crossed paths and not even known it.
Yeah, that's why I was like, you're from Renton. I'm from Renton, man. and there were so many clubs that we played at down there. I would guarantee that we've at least seen each other at one of these places back then. Back in 92 and 93, I was going to the Art Institute of Seattle, and I was hosting a public access TV show called Seattle Rocks at the time. And I was going to every club, because I don't know if you remember, but down in Pioneer Square, you pay one price and you get into 15 clubs.
Right, I do remember that.
Yeah, so I would frequent those clubs every night. And so I guarantee we've crossed paths.
Now, is the scene the same as it used to be back then?
Oh, no. Oh, no. It is not. I mean, back before 2000, you go downtown Seattle, any club, active music happening, hundreds of bands playing. Now it's like a ghost town. There's, you know, a few bands here and there, a couple of clubs that are good, that have a good act come in. It's more expensive, that's for sure. There's really and the music is definitely changed as far as playing styles, type of equipment used, sounds that are being made, and how the image of bands, it's all so different now.
Interesting.
That, yeah, and it's what's really crazy is I was just having this talk with Steve, the guitarist in the band, about how the club scene seems to be on its last leg. It's like dying, and it's kind of sad. But at the same time, shows like yours are what give me inspiration, because in my opinion, the internet scene is the new music scene. You don't have to play at a club. You just have to have good music, a good video, and a good following. And it's just like back in the day. You just play a song and everyone likes it. And then you get, you know, if you get enough likes, you start getting paid a click kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Back in the 90s and the 2000s, you play a club, you make 50 to 100 bucks, and you're just like, wow, all right, yeah, we'll play again next week. Where these days, you're lucky to get 20 bucks, and sometimes you drive from Seattle to Portland to play, and you don't get gas money to get back. And it's just like, ah.
It's the same here. I'll admit that. The music scene here has turned, believe it or not, to the tribute scene, because that's the scene that's drawing the people to the clubs, not the original band scene anymore. So I don't know if it's the same out there, but the tribute scene is huge out here. There's a tribute band for any band you can think of. There is one here.
Yeah, the tribute scene out here is very strong as well. I'd say it's 60-40, and the 60 is on the tribute side.
Well, enough of these tribute bands. We got to get back to Nothing Sounds Good. Who were your biggest influences? What got you into putting the band together?
Well, man, I've been playing music since I was 14, and I hate to tell you that I'm almost 50 right now, but, you know, I would say that some of my strongest influences would be Black Sabbath, Dio, Van Halen, Led Zeppelin, and more modern influences would be Soundgarden, Alice in Chains. But see, personally, I like everything from ABBA to Zappa. I mean, everything. I listen to all styles of music: country, rap, classical, jazz, piano, big band, concertos, whatever. I like all music, and that's the same goes with the guitarist Steve. He is classically trained. He's trained in jazz. He's trained in classic rock and metal and all kinds of different influences and styles. He's very virtuous, and he's really good. And our drummer, his influences are very, very modern, like, and also more on the mainstream metal, like Slipknot, Voivod, Sacred Reich, some older stuff. And then all of us kind of like, I don't know, Merciful Fate. Geez, what's one band we were all going to see the other day?
It sounds like you're cut from the same cloth as myself. That's why I moved to Seattle, because I had those very same influences, and I tried to be a rock star out there. I moved from here out there to try to do the whole rock star thing, because it was huge at the time. And
yeah, the 90s were a huge time for rock and roll in Seattle. I mean, what, Pearl Jam, Nirvana, Soundgarden were all taking off, Alice in Chains, and I was lucky enough that I was kind of walking in those circles, but not tight enough to get on the coattails of those bands. But like I said, the band, I kind of left Nothing Sounds Good for a little bit to join another band, and that band actually toured for a bit. We had a really good time. We were touring. I was a wannabe in a rock and roll band opening for has-beens like Twisted Sister and Blue Oyster Cult. We opened for Nazareth the night their drummer died. That was a turning point for me. That was actually an eye opener for me. It was crazy. The writer on their contract had $3,000 worth of booze on it. Ooh. And I'm just like, well, no wonder he died.
Yeah, no doubt, eh?
Yeah. But yeah, it was a, and then not too long after that, I got fired from that band, I'll be honest with you, and I got back with Nothing Sounds Good, and we just started tearing it up again, and we've been going pretty strong, and we recorded a couple of EPs here and there. We've got, actually, we've got one album that we recorded right when we got back together under a different name, just because we weren't sure if Nothing Sounds Good was going to be able to sell it.
So what's the creative process in writing the songs for Nothing Sounds Good?
Well, we just get together and we jam. And when the music starts feeling good, we put together the standard four change, and then play a six just to throw it off a little bit. And once we feel like we've gotten the music down tight enough, I will sit around and I will write lyrics all day. I will write words down on paper all day until I figure out something that I like. But then sometimes I come in with an idea lyrically, and Steve will write music around that as I kind of tell him what this idea is. And the next thing you know, we've got a song from it. It's not like we have one style that we choose to, let's come in and play this music and I'm going to sing these lyrics over it. Come in, play this music, I'm going to sing these lyrics over it. Ideas can come from anywhere, musically or lyrically.
And speaking of lyrically and musically, the song Doomsday, where did you get the inspiration for that?
Well, I was a little upset at our government. And quite timely, it really flows with what's happening right now, because to be candid, Doomsday is one of our older songs that we just brought back because it feels so timely now. We decided hey, let's pull out one of the old guns and fire it and see what happens. And the inspiration for Doomsday came from Bill Clinton and the NAFTA deal, as a matter of fact.
I was in Seattle at that time.
Yeah, that's how old that song is, and I'm surprised that it got as much traction as it did to become something that it has now.
Well, you know, what happens is, if you just send us tunes, and we keep telling bands, send us tunes, because we have a large enough audience and on enough stations that you're going to be able to get some traction somewhere.
Well, see, that's the beauty of the new music scene, I call it, because the internet is the new music scene. And it doesn't matter where you are or who you are, as long as you have something that connects with even one person, that one person will share it with a friend of theirs. Hey, check this out. This is great. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Or you could go the other way with that, where you write something so heinous and horrible, someone says, wow, check this out, it's terrible, and it goes viral because it's so bad. That's the beauty of the internet.
It is. Even the bad gets popular.
Oh, yeah. Sometimes the bad gets popular faster than the good.
So what's the goals for the band for 2018?
The goal for the band for 2018, now I hope you're sitting down.
We are.
I want to record an acoustic album.
Interesting.
I want to do, as a matter of fact, we've been messing around with Doomsday acoustically, and I want to do, I believe I sent you the song Mandy.
Yes.
I want to do that acoustically, and then I want to do a couple of cover tunes, like, I was thinking of doing For What It's Worth, and I was thinking of doing an old Traffic song. I can't think of the name of it right now. I'm under the gun.
There's a lot of pressure on this show, man. There's a lot of pressure.
Feeling All Right by Traffic.
Good tune.
Yeah, thinking about, we're kind of mulling that around, and we've been writing a lot of new stuff, and most of the time we just jam acoustically in my living room. So it's not a hard transition to go into the studio with the acoustic gear and write this stuff.
Any touring, any gigs coming up?
Our next gig is not until April 17th, and it's going to be at Tony V's up in Everett, which used to be Jimmy Z's when you lived here.
Let everybody know about your social media and websites, anything they can check you out on the internet.
Well, we've got Nothing Sounds Good on Facebook. We've got nothingsoundsgood.rocks, nothingsoundsgood.weebly.com, and we've got, what else do we have?
Reverb Nation, any of those?
Reverb Nation, SoundCloud, Tinder, Grindr, Plenty of Fish.
Plenty of Fish. Hey, you got to get those chicks, man.
Spreading it out there, baby. You can find us everywhere.
Okay, so, anything else you want to add before we let you go?
I would just like to say, John, thank you so very much for playing our song on your show. Thank you very much for the kudos and the award. And I can't, it hasn't been 12 weeks yet. I can't wait to get the care package. That's going to be awesome.
Yeah, it's coming. I'm waiting on a couple things before I can send those darn things out. Some of the stations are a little slow on that stuff. Well, I really appreciate you coming on, and please keep us up to date on anything going on with Nothing Sounds Good, any new material, if you got shows coming up, any updates, send them to me so I can like pass it on to the listeners, all right?
Oh, I will most definitely keep you and your listeners posted. Thank you so very much again for the opportunity.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Sleazy Vegetable Joe of Nothing Sounds Good.
Sounds Good.
We'll be right back.